Hello everyone. I'm going to give you a quick review of NVivo 15, which is a new NVivo version. As you can see here, this is NVivo 14. It has a circle icon, and NVivo 15 has a square icon. So you may ask, what is the main difference between NVivo 14 and 15? For the NVivo 15, you have AI assistant as a function that you can use to help you to analyze your qualitative data. So I'm going to go through with you and provide you all the information that you need so that you can use this function very well. So let's go to NVivo 15. You double click on NVivo 15. So this is what you see when you open NVivo 15. I just want to show you a quick information before I give you step by step how to use the new function. If you click on sample project, it will open the projects that are already there so that you can practice. You see here the new function is called AI Assistant. It will help you to summarize your document and then to develop quotes or theme to help you to address your research question that you have. So let me give you a brief information about it, and I'll be going into detail using my own data. When you go to files, let's go to file and go to interviews. Let's look at Barbara interview. So you double click on Barbara's interview. When you open, this is going to see about Barbara's transcript. If you want to summarize the transcript, you can just right click on here on Barbara's document and go to AI Assistant Summarize Document. So you click on that. And then you check to show that you have agreed to the terms, right? You cannot click on OK until you open the terms just to make sure that you read everything and you have agreed to all the conditions and information related to AI service that they are providing to you. So it looks like you're going to send your data to the third party. They didn't mention the third party, but I'm assuming that it's OpenAI GPT. So they send your data to their system, and then the system will be able to run and provide you a summary or provide you quotes. So this is just information about how your data will be processed using a third party. And they say that the information will not be used to train the AI model. So this is an assurance that your data will be protected based on what they are saying, and it will not be used to train the AI model. So that's the brief information about the agreement. After clicking on that, you can go back to NVivo and click on OK. So when you click on OK, this window comes. This is Barbara's transcript. You have an option. If you wanted to summarize it in any language that is here, you can choose the language, maybe Polish or Greek or German language, Spanish. Any language that is here, you can click on it. So I want it to summarize it in English. I choose English. And in terms of the length of the summary, you have choice. You can make it short. You can choose standard and also long, right? So based on my experience of using this, the summary ranges from 20 to about close to 200 words, right? I don't think it goes beyond 200. I haven't seen summaries that goes beyond 200. Things might change as time goes on because this is a new expansion. They might update it. But based on what I've learned, you get between 20 to 200 words, depending on what you choose here. So if you choose short, you click on generate, and within few seconds, you'll be able to get a summary of your document. So this is a summary, and we can check right now. We can copy and put it on a Word document so that you know the number of words that you're going to get. So this one is 67 words. We can try standard generate. And let's see. Let's check again. So this one is 160 words. Let's change it to long. Oh, this is more. I think this one would be closer to 200 words, right? It's 176. So this is how the summary is. When you finish generating, you have an option to add it as a memo. So you can save it as a memo. And then you can click add memo, right? And then click on OK. So when you do that, when you go to notes here, And then AI summaries, the summary will be here. You can double click on that. And then you see the summary for Barbara's interview, right? So you see it here. You can use it. I think this one will be very useful if you want to get a brief information about each of the interview, right? A big picture. And one of the limitations of using summary is that you may lose the uniqueness of the information that they gave you. Some of the information, because it's not maybe popular or frequently referenced, the summary will not capture that information. So you have to be aware that, using this one, there's a limitation. So the usefulness of using this summary is to get a brief idea about what participants were talking about, right? But if you really want to gain unique information from the data, it's very good for you to review the transcript, to go through line by line to extract significant information from the data. So yes, you can use this for summary. And when you also go into Barbara's document transcript, you can also select segments or excerpts and then ask the system to summarize this for you. Let's use this one example. So you can select this one, right click on it, and go to AI summary. So you see here that it gives you is summarizing text, right? So AI assistant summarize text. And then this is what you're going to see. It's quite similar to the previous one that we did. So you click on generate, and then it generates a summary for you. You can change it to standard or long if you want to. And then when you are done, you click on OK. Here, it's not going to go to memos. Because you selected information from the transcript, it will be indicated as annotation. So you see here, and if you want to see the annotation, you click on document and check here so that the information will be down here for you. See AI, and this is a summary. So now I've taught you two things. You can summarize the whole document and to go under memos. But you can also summarize a segment of the document that will go under annotation, right? So that's the two things that you have to note. So that is about summarizing document and also the segment of the document. What about developing codes? This one is a little bit unique in the sense that you have to first create containers. And then you go into the container and then run some analysis so that you can develop charred codes. Let me give you an example. As you can see here, we have economy as a container. And then under that, we have codes there. Imagine that you want to look into the information that was extracted and connected to economy, and you want to generate codes based on the information, based on the reference that you have. So you can see here that it has 486 references. So if you want to develop codes, what do you have to do using AI? You right-click on it and go to AI Assistant, and you click on that so that it will be able to suggest codes for you. And then you click on Generate. It will take some time because it has a lot of references. So you have to go through all the references. Now it has suggested codes for you. You can see here you have a list of codes based on the significant information. Whenever you click on any code, list of reference will be shown here, right? These are the significant information that were extracted from the data. So you can see that for environmental concern, these are the significant information that was extracted. There are five significant information. You see that one, two, three, four, five. Extracted. You have a lot of options here. If you don't like the code, you don't want it to be added under the parent code, you don't want to code that, you can uncheck, right? So if you uncheck, this means that the system will eliminate the code. Maybe you like the code, but you don't like the significant information that has been coded under that. You can also check this place, add refs. And what we'll do is that you'll see the code, but there will be no information under the code because you have already taken that information out. If you want to bring it back, you can also check that. Let's uncheck if you don't need the four significant information that has been connected to legacy and a way of life. You uncheck that, and then you click on OK. So when we go to the economy, as you saw earlier, there were already some codes there, right? Coded by WWS. Now, all the code that I just generated, coded by AI, to be indicated there so that you can differentiate between what the AI has coded and also what you have coded, right? So you can see that all the AI codes here, it shows here that way. You see the place where we checked that we don't want the references. See, you is 00. This means that there's nothing in this code because we checked that we don't want the references. And here we check that we want the references, and that's why we have the numbers here. So as you can see, the AI tool went through this container with the reference and then now generated themes or codes that represent the significant information. So how useful is this going to be? Let's say you have your research question. You can go through the data, extract information that is significant, and bring them under the research question. After that, you can allow the AI to help you to develop codes under that research question. And I think this is one of the usefulness of using AI. It's an assistant helping you to code. As you are coding and it reaches a state when you need the AI system, you can use it to help you to develop codes. And you know, the good thing is that you can always go back and review them. You can always go back and make an adjustment to the code by right-clicking on that and go to code properties. You can make any change that you want, right? That's the good thing about using this kind of tool. So this is what I have for you. I'm going to go into detail using my data, but I just want you to get a big picture about the new function and how to use it in a way that is going to be meaningful for you. You can also summarize a group of documents. How do you do that? You can select the ones that you want. Let's say I want these. I select them. I right-click. I go to AI Assistant. And then all the documents are here, right? Then I can select any one of them and summarize. So when I click on it, the system just generates. You see, when I click on it, it's generating, right? So you can click on it and then generate. After that, one by one, you can add them to the memo. So when I click on it, it goes to the next one. And I click on add memo. And when I finish, I click on OK. When you go back to memo, you have all the summarized information. You can click on one of them and open. So that's how you can summarize all the transcript at one time instead of doing it one by one. You may ask, how do you get access to this software? Let me show you. When you go to lumivero.com, you can get access to the software. So go to the main page, you can click on Buy Now. You can either buy or use the free trial, right? The free trial version, you can use it for 14 days. Let's say you are a student and you want to buy. You click on Buy Now, and then it takes you to this page, and you click on Select Options, and then you'll be able to go to annual subscription. Because you're a student, you only have annual subscription. And then you go to student licenses, is $118 per year. And then you have an option here. You can also add 250 to get annual subscription for AI assistant, right? So this one is useful if you want to frequently use the AI assistant. But if you're going to use it not a lot, you don't have to buy the AI assistant now. You still could be able to use the AI assistant, but in a limited form. As you continue to use and it reach your limit, the system will tell you to buy a subscription, right? So that you can have unlimited access to AI assistant. So for now, if you're a student, you don't have to buy additional 250 subscription. You can use the AI assistant in a limited form. If you reach your limit, you can decide whether you want to get annual subscription, which is additional 250. When you finish, you just click on add to cart, right? And then you'll be able to pay for the software. So that's all that I have for you.